Okay, once again, thank you all for coming this afternoon. My name is Dennis Normile, and I'll be the MC this afternoon. I'll just briefly, again, introduce the people at the head table. At the far end is our interpreter this afternoon, Lisa Ida. And then we have two men who face the loss of their land for the construction of the Ishiki Dam in Nagasaki Prefecture. Mr. Isamu Ishimaru and Mr. Kazuo Iwashita. In the middle, we have Takayuki Tsujii. He's general manager of Patagonia, Japan, who was involved with the production of this documentary. And to my immediate right is Mr. Masaru Itai, who is a lawyer representing the plaintiffs seeking to halt the construction of the dam. I'll just mention, probably even among my good friends here at the club, very few of them probably know that my background is in civil engineering. And I've been particularly interested in this trend in the United States where they've been taking down old dams. It's been something I've enjoyed watching. We're going to start with some comments from Mr. Tsujii, and we'll go from there. So, Mr. Tsujii.
All right, and hello everyone again. And I would like to thank all of you from my heart for taking time out of your busy schedule to watch the movie and to attend this press conference. And I would also like to extend my gratitude to Ms. Chan and Mr. Normile or Dennis-san and FCCJ to make this press conference possible. So I think I'll start. I would like to begin by speaking about the background as to why Patagonia made this film, DamNation, and why Patagonia Japan decided to support the movement against Ishiki Dam. So Patagonia has been manufacturing clothing for outdoor sports since 1973. Many of our employees are avid climbers, skiers, surfers, and fly fishers. And as we travel around the world, we have witnessed a massive destruction of nature with our own eyes. In addition to that, throughout the 40 years of experience being in apparel industry, we have learned that manufacturing clothing actually bring upon a lot of negative impact to the natural environment, as well as to the society and human rights. And that is why we think it is corporations' responsibility to use business itself to implement the solution to solve the environmental crisis and to resolve other issues that we have in our society. So saving the natural state of rivers is a major point of interest for people like us. Upon focusing on the power of visual images, we created this film so that the issues on dams in the United States can be known by a broader range of people. On reflection, there are 2,800 dams in this country of Japan, which we live in. We refer to those exceeding 50 meters in height as dams in Japan. However, if we include the smaller ones, it is said that there are close to 100,000 dams in this country. You have all seen the harmful effect of dams in the film. It is unfortunate that in Japan, what we gain and what we lose in relation to the dams from an economical, social, cultural, and environmental perspective are not being evaluated in an objective manner. Despite such state, there are still multiple dam construction being planned currently. Among those dams, we think that the Ishiki Dam plan, which I will explain about today, lacks in objective necessity from various perspectives. So I will talk about the general outline of the plan from here on. So the construction site of the dam is located south of Sasebo City in Nagasaki Prefecture on Kyushu Island, right around here. And here is the small Ishiki River, which is a tributary of this wider, longer Kawatana River. These are the images of the area and the Ishiki River, which is very narrow and small, as you can see. This is an image of the finished dam taken from the website of Kyushu's Developmental Bureau with numbers I added here. Oops, sorry. The size, myself. This is a bird's eye view of the area. The image shown in the previous page is viewed as seen from the direction of this red arrow, like this. The yellow line, which goes around the area, shows the planned construction site of the incidental road. And if the dam is constructed, this whole area inside the road will be submerged. If seen from the other side, it looks like this, and it will look like this. And this house, which is the home of Ishimaru-san, sitting with us today, will also be submerged. The plan to construct the dam was brought upon in 1962, more than 50 years ago. However, it was November of 2009 that the Nagasaki Prefecture and Sasebo City, which are the business owners advocating the dam, filed for business authorization based on the land expropriation law. The business authorization was announced on September 6, 2013, and on September 5, 2014, a year later, the business owners, Nagasaki Prefecture and Sasebo City, filed for a compulsory expropriation procedure. So to begin with, the objective of this of building this dam was mainly for, one, to secure the water for Sasebo City, and two, control the flood of Kawatana River, not the Ishiki River itself. We think that both of the points do not make sense. The first point, in regards to the securing the water, I'm sorry, it's a very small graph, but I will explain. Graph on the left indicating Sasebo City's actual and estimated maximum public water use per day. And on the right side, you see the graph indicating estimated population of Sasebo City in the future. So Sasebo City has claimed that the maximum water use per day will increase as much as 25% in 5 years, which is shown in red. The blue line is the actual, the red one is the line is the estimate of the city. However, it was proven to lack any objective grounds through the process entailing replies given in response to the open letter of inquiry submitted by the team of lawyers and so on. So in regards to the flood control, the mayor of Kawatana Town, who is sitting on the right side with black suits, declared at the public meeting held on July 11th, 2014, these are his words. I have received the explanation, and it is my understanding that by repairing the channel of Kawatana River, it is possible to prevent water disasters that are of the same level as those occurs in the past, even without the Ishiki Dam. So if this dam, which has no objective necessity, as I have been trying to explain, gets constructed, it will result in impacting 138 wildlife and plantation species that exist at the proposed site and are listed in the nation's and prefecture's red data book. In addition to those reasons, Another reason we feel this plan should be reevaluated is the existence of the memorandum exchange between Nagasaki Prefecture and the local residents in 1972. In exchange for the promise that the plan will not proceed without the agreement of the residents, the local residents exchanged a memorandum which listed their consent to the basic inspections being carried out. Even with such fact, 23 individuals, including landowners and supporters, were sued recently for obstructing construction work when the city workers tried to restart the incidental road construction. Unfortunately, the Sasebo City Court ruled that 16 of those people must not further obstruct the construction work this past March 24th. So at this point, about 54 billion yen of precious tax money is about to be used for this unnecessary Ishiki Dam. We truly hope that the validity of constructing this dam will be publicly discussed in a calm, scientific, and objective manner. At last, I would like to share that the Japan Federation of Bar Association, which all lawyers in Japan are registered with, have also made public their written opinion stating their request to halt the construction of this dam. Today, we have Mr. Itai, who is a lawyer and the sub-leader of the team of lawyers against the Ishiki Dam, seated here with us. If there is anything you would like to know from a legal perspective, please inquire with Mr. Itai-san during the Q&A session to follow. Thank you very much for your kind attention. That's it from me.
Do the landowners want to make any comments before we accept questions?
I know. Here, these two are going to make a speech.
Okay. Now we'll hear from who's going first?
Ishimaru-san.
Mr. Ishimaru.
ここにお集まりの皆様、私たちのために記者会見の場を作っていただき感謝いたします。私は石木ダム建設計画地の住民で Ishimaru Isamu と申します。もう半世紀近くダム問題で苦しめられています。私たちの人生の大半はダム問題に翻弄され続けた人生だと言っても過言ではありません。これからも続くと覚悟はしておりますが、なんとかこのダム建設を止めたいと考えています。
To all those who have gathered here, I hereby wish to express my most sincere gratitude for this press conference opportunity you have created for us. My name is Isamu Ishimaru, and I am a resident of the proposed area for the dam construction. We have suffered for close to half a century with issues pertaining to the dam, and it is not an exaggeration to state that our lives have been continuously impacted by the dam problems. I am prepared for this issue to continue from here on. However, I am determined to somehow stop the construction of this dam.
Ishiki Dam 建設予定地は日本の原風景が残る素晴らしいところだとよく言われます。私の住む神原は今、石木川のほとりに黄色の帯のように菜の花が咲いています。初夏にはホタルが飛び交い、秋にはコスモスの花が咲きます。素朴な里に13戸60人が家族のように助け合い、質素ながらも心豊かに暮らし、石木川流域の自然を守っています。
The area slated for the Ishiki Dam construction is often said to be a place where the beauty of Japan's nature remains unchanged. The area I live in, called Kobaru, now boasts a yellow obi of nanohana blossoming alongside the Ishiki River. We have fireflies crossing the skies during the early summer and cosmos blooming in the fall. 13 households and 60 residents reside in this modest village, helping each other out like family and protecting the Ishiki River watershed as we live a simple but fulfilling life.
実は日本のダム行政は最初にダムありきでダムを作ること自体が目的で、そのダムが必要かどうかは後付けなのです。そしてそれを追認していく日本のシステムに問題があります。審議される過程も第三者委員会とは名ばかりで、中身は身内による身内のための制度になっているからです。私たちはこの行政を相手に苦しい戦いを続けてきました。
In reality, Japan's dam administration is based purely on the concept of building a dam first and foremost, with the validation of the dam's necessity a mere afterthought. In addition, the problem lies within Japan's system, which continues to ratify the situation. The deliberation process, which they claim is conducted by a third-party panel, is in fact one comprised of relations, following a system made to solely benefit their own people. We have been in this very difficult fight for many, many years.
現在、企業者は土地収用法をかざして、私たちの土地や家、立木などを強制的に取り上げようと手続きを進めています。実は、水没予定地の一部は、太平洋戦争中に軍需工場の疎開先として、日本海軍の強制収用を受けた歴史があります。戦時中の強制収用は明治憲法の下で当時の軍事政権が行ったことです。今回は当時とは全く違います。私の友人は日本国憲法第13条を取り出して憲法に規定されている権利が上位で強制収容は憲法違反だから頑張れと励ましてくれます。生命、自由及び幸福追求の権利を基本理念とする民主的な現在の日本国憲法の下で、この憲法第13条を無視して、いとも簡単に強制収容が行われてはならないと言っているのです。該当署名でも強制収容だけは絶対に行ってはならないと多くの人が理解を示してくれていますが、企業者の暴走が気になります。
Currently, the business promoters advocating the dam, which are Nagasaki Prefecture and Sasebo City, are proceeding with the process to forcefully take away our land, home, and own trees by using the land expropriation law.Actually, a portion of the area scheduled to be submerged has a history of being placed under forced expropriation by the Japanese Navy for use as their military supply factories evacuation site during the World War II. The compulsory expropriations conducted during the war were implemented by the military regime under the Meiji Constitution. What we are facing now is a totally different situation.My friend brought out the Constitution of Japan's Article 13, which speaks of basic human rights, informing me that the authorization stipulated in the Constitution takes priority and that a forced land expropriation is an infringement of the Constitution, and he has encouraged me to keep fighting. He explained that under the current democratic Constitution of Japan that holds the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness as its fundamental principles,The opposing party simply cannot ignore Article 13 and carry out a forced land expropriation as if it meant nothing. As we collect petitions on the streets, many people show their understanding that a forced expropriation must not, by any means, be carried out. However, I am most concerned about the reckless direction the dam proponents are taking.
私の田んぼも強制収容の最初の対象地になっています。近々収容採決が出ると聞いていますが、収容採決されても田んぼを作り続けるつもりです。今年も耕作の準備を始めました。 手前味噌ですが、交番の米はとても美味しいのです。できればここで皆さんに食べていただきたいくらいでした。黄金色の稲穂の美しさ、自分で作った安全安心のご飯を食べるとき、私は幸せを感じます。戦後繁栄し贅沢になった日本ですが、これこそ真の贅沢であり最高の幸せです。この幸せを子や孫に残していかなければなりません。この田んぼを守り続けていかなければなりません。
My rice fields are also targeted as part of the first wave of forced expropriation. I have heard that the judgment on this issue will be reached soon. However, I plan to keep tending my fields even if the decision falls into the opposition's favor. I have already started to prepare for the cultivation of my fields. And if I may sing my own praise, the rice made in Kobaru is very delicious. If it were at all possible, I wish that I could have all of you taste it today right here. Seeing the beauty of the golden years of the stalks and eating the safe, comforting rice grown by our own hands are when I feel so very blessed. Japan has prospered since the war, but I think that these simple things are the ultimate luxuries and true happiness. We must leave these blessings for our children and grandchildren, and we must continue to protect these fields.
水はないよりあった方がよい。でも強制収容までしてダムを作らなければならない理由はどこにもありません。私たちは不要なダムのためにこのふるさとを水の底に沈められることがどうしても我慢できないのです。
Water is a necessity, that I know. However, in this case, there exists no reason to construct a dam, much less one that requires forced expropriation. We simply cannot bear to witness our precious birthplace be submerged due to an unnecessary dam.
義は私たちにありと自信を持っていますが、悲しいかな、今の日本の政治は理にかなっていません。自然は破壊され続けています。私たちは今、窮地に立たされています。ご支援をよろしくお願いいたします。
I do have the confidence that justice will be served, yet I am saddened. Japan's current political state is not logical, and the natural world continues to be destructed, and we are forced to stand on dire grounds, and we sincerely ask for your support. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Iwashita.
Iwashita-san, please.
私は石木ダム建設予定地の地権者の一人であります岩下和夫といいます。68歳です。石木ダム建設によって3地区67世帯の住民が移転を余儀なくされました。私たちが住んでいる高原地区は全住民が移転の対象となります。
My name is Kazuo Iwashita, 68 years old and one of the landowners of a property on the proposed Ishiki Dam construction siteDue to the construction of the Ishiki Dam, 67 households of three regions have been forced to move out. And the entire region of Kobaru, where I live, has been subjected to this enforcement.
Kobaru 地区は34世帯と小さな集落ではありましたが、昔から地区作業道路の舗装や町の山林を委託管理、植え付けから草刈り、枝打ち、間伐と地区住民が協力し合って作業を行ってきました。夏の暑い日の作業は大変でしたが、山での弁当、作業後の先輩たちの昔話、自慢話に聞き入り、楽しく過ごせた思い出がたくさんあります。
The Kobaru region was a small village of just 34 households. However, the residents have always worked together, whether it was to pave the roads or consigning, replanting, pruning, and thinning out the trees in the mountains. Working on those hot summer days were quite hard, but I have so many good memories of us having fun as we enjoyed our lunch on the mountains and listened to our predecessors playfully boasting about all their past feats.
農繁期の忙しい時期には田植え稲刈りと近隣同士でお互い手伝いをするような 隣人愛豊かな地区でありました。しかし伊敷ダム建設計画が持ち上がると、最初は一緒にダム建設に反対されていた方々が行政の説得に負け、賛成派と反対派に地区が二分され、先祖が作り上げてきた隣人愛あふれる豊かな環境が破壊され、地区の行事をはじめ老人会、婦人会など一緒に参加できなくなり、悲しい結果を招きました。
It was also once a region where love and consideration for each other were abundant, as witnessed during the busy farming season when neighbors helped each other out to plant and harvest the rice we grew. However, once the plan for the Ishiki Dam surfaced, some of the residents who had opposed to the plan eventually gave in to the government's persuasion, and the region saw a rift between those who succumbed and those who remained opposed to the dam. This destroyed a wonderful world which our ancestors had built, where neighbors truly cared for each other. It also brought about such sad consequences where we were no longer able to participate together in the village's annual events, such as the women's committee meetings, senior citizen gatherings, and so on.
40数年間と長いダム反対運動の中で、ダム建設を白石化させるまで一緒に戦っていこうと誓い合った仲間の中からも、将来の設計生活設計が立てられなく、長い戦いに負け、泣く泣くふるさとを後にされた方もあります。しかし、私たちは行政の圧力にも負けず、今までふるさとを守り続けてきました。
During the 40-plus years in our movement against this dam, some of the folks who swore to fight with us until the plans were completely revoked became unable to carry on as they lost sight of their future livelihood and lost the long battle, tearfully leaving their beloved homes behind. Despite this, we stood strong against the pressure from the administration, and we still continue to do all we can to protect our homeland.
今は13世帯と少ない集落となりましたが、同じ意見を共有する者同士、絆は強く、家族のような付き合いをしています。地区の行事も、子どもから老人会まで全員参加して、春には花見、秋には敬老会、年に一度の小旅行など、家族一丸となって、和気あいあいと楽しんでいます。私は、私の住んでいるこの地区が、ダムの話がなければ、世界で一番いいところだと思っています。
The village now is a small one with just 13 households. However, we all share the same thoughts, and our ties are as strong as that of a real family. Everyone from children to elderly participate in the village's annual events, where we enjoy ohanami under the cherry blossom trees in the spring, a respect for the elderly event in the fall, and we even go on a once a year short trip, enjoying our time together as one big family. I believe that if it weren't for this dam, this land where I live is without doubt the best place in the world.
毎年5月の最終土曜日には13世帯が中心となるホタル祭りを行っています。近隣の町、市からたくさんの方が見られ、伊敷川沿いにたくさんのホタルが乱舞するのを見られ、歓喜されます。私たちはこのような自然豊かなふるさとを未来へ残していかなければなりません。ふるさとを後にされた方々が戻ってこられる環境を守っていかなければなりません。不必要なダムからふるさとを守るのが私たちの義務なのです。これからもダム建設計画がなくなるまで反対運動を続けていきます。
On the last Saturday of May, the 13 households will get together to host an annual Hotaru Matsuri, or Firefly Festival. All the people from neighboring towns and cities are so delighted when they see the many fireflies dance around the Ishiki River. We must leave places like this where nature's beauty exists for the future. We have to keep protecting this place so that those who left have a place to come back to. It is our responsibility to protect our homeland from the construction of an unnecessary dam, and I will continue to keep opposing to this dam until the plans are completely withdrawn.
最後にこのような場を設けていただいた、パタゴニアの方々と今日 お集まりいただいた 報道関係者の皆様へ感謝を申し上げます。どうもありがとうございます。
Lastly, I wish to express my sincere gratitude to Patagonia for creating this opportunity and to all of you in the media who have gathered for us here today. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you. We will move right into Q&A, starting with members of the working press. If anyone has any questions, please come up, give your affiliation and your name. Yes, Siegfried.
Siegfried Knittel, freelancer from Germany. How many electricity will be produced, would be produced by the new dam? And could not be said in a time of nuclear power is an everyone knows about the danger of nuclear power, and hydropower is a clear energy. Would this be a kind of an argument for building this dam?
And so will it be an argument for
building?
For the construction of the dam.
はい、ドイツからのフリーランスの、ジャーナリストの方からいただいたご質問です、このダムで、もしこのダムが実行、まあ、計画が実行された場合どのぐらい の電力が、供給されるのでしょうか、今世界中では もちろんその原発がどれだけ、危険を伴っているかということを理解している中、ハイドロ、水力によって、発生される電力はクリーンであるという認識を持っている方が多いので、それを、まあ、説得材料として、その建設関連の方たちが、まあ、このダムを推進していくのではないかということを、お聞かれになりました。
じゃあ日本語で、失礼しますけれども、入ってますかね。このダムに関しては、水力発電は行われないです。There is no plan to produce any power out of this dam. This is only for the to secure the water and to flood to control the flood.Those are the two main reasons. このダムに関しては電力の発電ではなくて、まあ、利水、主に、まあ、水道水ですけど、その他の、水を確保する。それから、先ほどの石木川ではなくて本流の方の川棚川の、治水、まあ、洪水を防ぐという2つの目的になっています。それから水力発電が、まあ、環境に配慮した持続可能な電力だということが長く言われてきたんですけれども、近年になって例えばダム湖の水が汚染されてメタンガスが発生するということが分かってきています。メタンガスというのは地球温暖化に対して CO2 より35倍悪影響があるというふうにも言われています。それから魚の問題、映画でも見てもらったような問題もありますし、また堆積物ですね、ダム湖にたまる、まあ本来であれば流れる下流に流れる土砂がたまることによって、河口に養分がいかなくなるということも分かっています。例えば日本で唯一撤去が決まって今工事が行われている荒瀬ダムでは、河口で海苔の養殖をされている方々がダムがあった50年間は海苔が数十センチにしかならなかったのが、まあ、3メーターまでダムの撤去が決まって放水があった後に伸びたというような話もありますので、必ずしも水力発電がクリーンなエネルギーだというふうには言い切れないということだと思います。
In reference to your point about hydro energy being quite acknowledged as a clean energy. In the recent years, it has been proven otherwise. It is not considered a sustainable source of energy. And the reasoning behind that is due to the fact that a lot of sediment or blue-green algae will occur in the dam reservoir, which produces a lot of methane gas. And the methane gas is considered to be 35 times more toxic or harmful than CO2. And in addition, the sediments that gather at the bottom of the dam prohibits nutrients from flowing downstream. So if we take the example of the one dam that was taken away or demolished and is being in the process of being demolished in Japan, the Arase Dam, the people who were growing seaweed at the downstream of that dam noticed that their seaweed grew exponentially. Initially, it was a few centimeters, but it grew to almost 3 meters in length as soon as the river was flowing again after the dam was removed.
Few centimeters, 50 centimeters around, 2-3 meters.
Two, three meters height.
Sorry, it was a long answer. I'll try to keep it simple for the next one.
Further questions? Are you working press?
Yes.
Yes? Okay, please.
Sorry. Elaine Kurtenbach, Associated Press. I have so many questions, but I'll just start with Mr. Tsujii for starters and ask a couple. Is Patagonia involved in any other dam-related projects in Japan in terms of supporting people who are against them? I know there's a lot of dams that are being advocated against or whatever. And also, from your perspective, how is it that there doesn't seem to be much in the way of civil, like, disobedience-type movements to deal with these issues? Obviously, these dams haven't been built, so you can't paint a crack in them in this particular case, but I'd be interested to hear your perception on that.
Sorry, Elaine, I'm not wearing my glasses. I couldn't.
Yes, we have been supporting other dam removal movement as well as to stop the dam. One is the Sanru dam planned in Hokkaido, Sanru Gawa, not Sanru Dam. And then the second is to try to open the gate of Nagara River, Kakozeki, the river mouth, small dam. And then the third is the Seto Ishi Dam in Kyushu, which is actually upstream of that Arase Dam, which I mentioned. 2つ目は長良川の河口関の開門の問題、それから3つ目は先ほどの球磨川の荒瀬ダムの上流にもう1つ瀬戸石というダムがあるんですけれども、その3つに対しての支援も行っていますし、 and then also we have been donating 1% of revenue to the grassroots environmental groups, and those includes some of the people who are working against the dam. それからあの売上の 1% を草の根の環境団体に寄付をしてるんですけど、その中にはダム関連の反対活動を行っている方々がいらっしゃいます。2つ目の質問。はい。北海道、言いました。1つ目はすいません、はっきり聞こえなかったかもしれないんですが、北海道のサンル川に建設が予定されているサンルダムです。
So may I clarify your question once more, Elaine? I'm sorry.
The second
one? The question is in regards to the civil disobedience. So you, Han Dam ni taisuru so you eiga de utsutteta yona sono rakugaki wo kaitari so itta koto.
Ma, hitotsu wa kore boku no kojintekina iken ni narimasu kedo, hitotsu damu no owner ga, amerika no oku no baai wa プライベートカンパニーというか、あの企業が持っている場合が、あるのと、あるが多くて、国や州が持っているものは少ない。で、日本では、ほとんどのケースが州や国が持っているということで、あの活動が非常にあの、状況が違って難しいということがあると思います。
This is my personal opinion, but one issue that differs between U.S. and Japan is that in the U.S., many of the dam owners are private, they're owned by private companies, and not many are owned by the state. However, in Japan, the reverse is true, where many of the dams are owned by the prefectures or the cities.
で、あの、2つ目の、背景は、まあ、石木ダムのケースもそうなんですけれども、佐世保の市民の方々の多くの方々はこのダムがまだ必要だというふうに思っていらっしゃると思います。つまり、市および、事業主側が、このダムの必要性というのを、いろいろな手法を使って、まあ、プロモートをしているので、まだ、ダムに関する現状について、人々の関心や、事実関心が薄いということや事実があまり知られてないということが2つ目にあるんじゃないかというふうに僕は、感じています。
And the other issue contributing to the fact that there are not many civil disobedience or other issues going on is that for Ishiki Dam, the Sasebo citizens, many of them still are under the impression that this dam is actually necessary, which in turn means that the city and the government has been promoting the need quite effectively to these people. And so the awareness of the fact that this dam is just not necessary, and as well as the understanding of the actual facts themselves, it's quite weak amongst the Sasebo citizens.
Okay, I wonder if, all right, Patrick. I wonder if you could just clarify exactly what is the situation with the Ishiki Dam. Is there any, construction has started. What would be necessary to stop the construction of the dam?
So, Mr. Itai is going to answer that question.
Okay. So, 日本語ですね。今の、あの、デニスさんからのご質問なんですが、あの、今のこの石木ダムの現状と、まあ、その建設がどの程度進んでいるのか、そして何を具体的にすれば阻止ができるのか、これ以上の建設。はい、
あの、弁護士の遺体です。現時点ではまだダムそのものの工事は行われていません。ダムを作るための取り付け道路、これをどうしようかということで、今、作業が、長崎県と佐世保市でなされています。
So currently, my name is Itai, lawyer Itai. Currently, the dam construction has not been implemented at this point. They are between Nagasaki Prefecture and Sasebo City. They are currently discussing what to do to proceed with the construction and how to go about it.
今何をどうすればいいのかということなんですが、私どもの弁護団、石木ダム対策弁護団というんですが、福岡と長崎と熊本で合計10名の弁護士がいます。で、今問題にしているのは裁判ということよりも、むしろこの住民の方々が何を言いたいのか、特に一番問題にしているのはダムが本当に必要なのかどうか、このことを長崎の県民の方々、それからまあ九州や日本の国民の方々、それからまあ世界的にもですね、本当にダムが必要なのかどうかということを明らかにすることが大事なことではないのかなというふうに思っています。で、私どもが今していることは、まあ、簡単に言うとですね、長崎県知事と佐世保市長に対して公開質問状を出しています。そしてそれに基づいて公開の、なんていうんですかね、討論会というんですか、そういうものをしています。そしてそれに基づいて長崎県知事がこういう、 佐世保の市長が水道局がこういうということを明らかにしてですね、それをこの4月から5月にかけて、ブックレットという形で、それぞれの言い分をはっきりと、本にして表そうというふうに思っています。で、そういうことをしてですね、とにかくこの問題、そのダムの必要性がないにもかかわらず53年前に建てた計画をですね、今でもご利用しようとしているという、この事実を明らかにしたいというふうに思っています。まずそのことが大事だというふうに思っています。以上です。
はい。And as to your second question on what we can do, specifically do to halt the construction or the progress of the Ishiki Dam plan, my opinion is that, well, as a fact, the lawyers united against the construction of the Ishiki Dam is comprised of 10 lawyers from Fukuoka, Nagasaki, and Kumamoto prefectures. And our interest at this point is to not take this to court, but actually take the voices of the residents and their concerns to the public, and not just to Nagasaki or Kyushu or all of Japan, but hopefully eventually to the world at large. And so we would like to place the utmost importance on clarifying exactly how the residents feel about the dam and the fact that this dam is totally unnecessary. And in the past, we have sent out an open letter of inquiry to the Nagasaki Prefecture's governor and the mayor of Sasebo City. And we have conducted several public debates on this issue. And so what we would like to do between the months of April and May is to compile all the findings or all the discussions that were held during the public debate and clearly write out what the Nagasaki prefectural mayor had said, or sorry, the governor had said, and the Sasebo Water Bureau had said. So we just want to list out all the facts so that many of the people will be much more aware of why we believe this dam is not valid. And the last point is that this is a construction plan that surfaced 53 years ago, and it lacks in total validity, but these people, the administration, are still trying to enforce it upon the people. And so we want to make that fact clear as well.
Okay, Patrick.
Actually asked one of my questions. Thank you very much. Patrick Sonner, Zürcher Zeitung from Switzerland. You've been fighting for 50 years against this dam. How do you think can you keep up this fight? You live in a very lovely place, but these are usually not the places where young people live. These are places which fight anywhere with depopulation. So how do you think you can keep up this fight? And my second question maybe to the two people to the right. Are there any examples in Japan where dams have been stopped by public opposition?
Hi. スイツランドのパトリックさんからのご質問です。まずはじめに、まあ、このダム計画に対して50年以上も反対運動をされているということですが、でその拝見させていただくと、その予定地も本当に自然豊かな素晴らしい場所だと思います。ただやはりこういったところでは若い方たちがなかなか定着せず、まあ、そのどんどんその町を村を離れていく傾向が見られると思うのですが、今後長い目で見てどのようにその反対活動を継続されると思っていますかというのが一つ目のご質問です。はい、じゃあ We'll take it one question at a time.
私の地区では、3世代4世代と、生活しております。それで若い人たちも地元に残り一緒に生活しております。今後も、若い人たちの運動にも今日は見えてませんけど、若い人たちも運動に参加し一緒に運動を続けております。でも今回来る前に、昨日、地区の花見を行いましたけど、若い者が中心になり大会をやっております。
はい。 So in reality, the village or the community that I live in, it consists of 3 to 4 different generations. We all live together, and there are many, many young people who have decided to remain there and are living there together with us. And although the presence of those young folks within our village is not here today, they are not here today, they are still very active in supporting us against our supporting us in the movement against this dam. And right before we came here, we held the annual Ohanami, cherry blossom viewing party, but that event is always hosted by the young people. They take the initiative to put it all together, and so they are very, very active in their support against the dam. The second question, 日本の中で、まあ、国内で、市民の反対によって、ダム建設が、阻止された 事例はありますかという、
今日は実はちょっとあちらの席に、水源連の遠藤さん、という方がいらっしゃってまして、日本で、全国のダムの、関連の活動をされていますので、ちょっと遠藤さんの方から、ご紹介いただければと思いますが。
Today we have with us Mr. Endo of the Japan River Keeper Alliance, or Seigenden. And so he has been involved in dam issues in Japan for many, many years and is well versed. So we would like to hear his take on this.
遠藤と申します。今のご質問にお答えいたします。日本にもですね、たくさんその事例はあります。国のダムに対してはですね、細河内ダムという大きなダムが計画がありました。それから紀伊仁淀川ダムというようなですね、ダムの計画がありまして、細河内ダムは村全体が反対をして中止になりました。それから紀伊仁淀川ダムはですね、流域の人たちが住民運動で反対をして、それで中止になっております。でその他に各自治体ね、県レベルで の計画に対してはですね、島近くのダムがですね、反対運動で中止にを獲得しております。でまあ、日本の場合には、まあ、住民運動で止めたというのは約10ですね、10のダムがあります。
I will clarify the names of the dam later on, just to make sure that I have it accurate. But there are several examples of dams in Japan being halted due to the movement from the public from the citizens. For the nation, dams owned by the nation itself, there is the. お名前をもう一度確認させていただいていいですか？細野内。細野内。The Hosogochi Dam, where the whole. In Tokushima Prefecture, which the whole village was against, and the whole plan was halted. And the second one was? Kii-Niugawa Dam. Hi. And that is in Wakayama Prefecture. And this plan was also halted due to the residents' efforts. And these residents lived around the watershed of that river. As for the prefectural level dams, there is also the Tomochikaku. Would that be right? Hi. Tomochikaku. This has also been halted by the citizens' efforts. Tomochikaku, sorry. About 10 dams on the prefectural level have been halted by the efforts of the residents. Excuse me, 10 dams. Hi.
Okay, Mr. Endo, for the benefit of our journalists, could you give us your full name, please, and its spelling?
Hi, Endo-san, 他のジャーナリストの記録のために、お名前を、下のお名前と名字をもう一度いただいてもよろしいですか？
遠藤康夫と申します。
Mr. Yasuo Endo with the Japan River Keeper Alliance.In Japanese is Suigenden.
Machigai nai yo ni, Endo wa E-N-D-O de shou ka. So shite Yasuo, Y-A-S-U-O de shou ka. Hi. And where is your association based? In what city?
水源連の所在地はどちらの方になるでしょうか? It's listed on the fact sheet that we have submitted to you, which I will pull out right now.
Kanagawa Prefecture.
Where is it?
Okay. It's in Kanagawa Prefecture. There is a fact sheet with the same photo on the top, and then at the bottom, there is the address, Kanagawa, Yokohama City. It's the location of the head office of this association.
Okay. Other questions? Yes, Roger.
Yes. 日本語でフリーランスで佐藤と申しますけれども、確か小泉内閣っていうのが過去にですね、骨太の方針っていうので、ダムの建設の事業が長期化している場合ですね、何十年とか経っているやつは見直すということで、100近いダムの確か計画見直して、中止になったりとかですね、もう一回計画元ゼロからやり直しとかいろいろなことがあったんですけども、石垣ダムというのはなぜそういうことがあったにも、その中止にならずにですね、事業は継続ということになったか、その判断が多分あったと思うんですよね。でそれがどういうふうな経緯で石垣ダムというのは30年40年と経っているのにもかかわらず作るということになったのか、でそれがもちろん長崎県とかそういう人たちのためになっているのかっていうのは一つと、あと石垣ダムの流域って確か平成2年ぐらいに洪水が多分あったと思うんですけども、そういうことに関してですね、そのためにダムを作るっていうのはなんていうんですかね、すごい大前提みたいなことになってるんですけども、その辺の危険性みたいなものについては起こらない、今後起こらないとも限らないですよね、洪水とかそういう災害が。でそのことについては起きてしまっても仕方ないなというふうに地元の皆さんは思っているのかということ、この2点についてちょっとお伺いしたいんですけども、はい、ちょっと意地悪な質問で申し訳ないですけど、ちょっとそれはちょっと聞いてみたいなと思います、はい。
Okay, this is a question from Mr. Sato, freelance writer. During the Koizumi administration, there was a plan called the Honebuto Plan, where dams that had been in existence as a plan had been re-evaluated. And as a result, many of the dam plans were halted and did not proceed any further. So the question is, why did the Ishiki Dam not be subject of re-evaluation during the Koizumi administration? And we do understand that this dam is possibly could be for the Nagasaki people. And the other point is that Ishiki River, back in Heisei Ninen, which will be about, technically it's in 1990, when the last flood had occurred, and the dam, if it's for a flood control, many people probably do think that the dam will be effective in preventing such a flood from occurring or any other water disasters from occurring. So my second question is, I would like to hear from the residents on their take of how they see the possibility of a flood or another water disaster occurring if the dam does not get constructed. Okay. The first question will be addressed by Mr. Endo.
Ishiki Dam のですね、見直しがされたのは、当時の今言わ記者さんが言われていた、亀井静香さんが建設大臣をしていた時にかなりのダムが中止になりましたけれども、その時の中止の対象のダムに石破さん入ってましたっけ？入ってなかったですね。中止の対象ダムに入っていなかったと記憶しています、私は。
So I recall, as far as the, as to the question as to why the Ishiki Dam was not part of the re-evaluation conducted by the Koizumi administration, I recall that the Ministry of Construction at that time did not include Ishiki Dam in the list of dams to be re-evaluated.
それから長良川河口堰が まあ、稼働するしないのかわかんないので、稼働が決まった時点でしばらくしてから、国のダムのですね、見直しは、行った経緯はありますけども、この時も石木ダムは国のダムでないので、見直しから外れております。
Nagaragawa, hi. So when they decided to operate the Nagaragawa Dam, the administration did not include Ishiki Dam as part of the reevaluation because it's not a nation-owned dam.
2009年から政権交代で、その時に 140のダムが 計画中、事業中であったんですけども、それらを全部見直すということに、最初はそういう動きがありました。
And back in 2009, when the change of administration had occurred in the Japanese government, 140 dams were initially going to be reevaluated. That was the initial plan.
で、結果的には、イシキダムもその対象になりました。
And as a result, Ishiki Dam was included in the 140 dams to be reevaluated.
ただし、見直しをするのは県が見直しをするということで、イシキダムの場合は企業者が自ら見直しをするというシステムになっていたわけです。
However, the system worked as such that for the Ishiki Dam reevaluation, the prefecture stated that they will be responsible for the actual reevaluation process as because the prefecture was the business owner or the promoter of the dam plan.
で、その見直しの時にですね、今後の水の利水面で言うならば、佐世保市の水の需要があるのかないのかという見直しをもちろんしています。 その見直しがですね、しているというだけでありまして、実際には科学的根拠は全くなく、もう全くこうデタラメな見直しで、イシキダムが必要だという結論になっています。
Reevaluation or the process or the content of what was included in the reevaluation process, it entails Sasebo City discussing about the need for their municipal water or securing enough water for their citizens. The fact is that they said that they did reevaluate and look at the figures, but it lacked any scientific ground and the numbers were completely fabricated.
ずっと今まで下がっていたのに突然グーッとさっきのグラフでありましたけどもね。あ、このグラフですね。はい。
So as you can see on this graph here, when I say that the evaluation process was completely fabricated, is because their estimation was absurd. You can see the need for water decreasing and all of a sudden showing a very, very rapid increase.
実績はこんなに下がっているんですけども。This
is the actual use.
突然こう上がるという。
And the estimation shows a very steep increase in
red. それからもう一つは保有宣言の評価です。
保有宣言 will be
保有宣言
水源 to sorry to secure enough water the reservoir.
でこれをですね、約2万8000トンを きちっとした根拠なく使えない水源だというふうに見なしておりまして、で水源が足りない足りないと言っているわけです。
So another fact that they are pushing as a fact is not is that they are saying that they need to secure more water for the public use and they're saying that they need 28,000 tons.
28,500.
28,500 tons. Hi.
それからあとは、はい。じゃあ二つ目の質問は岩下さんありがとうございます。はい。遠藤さんありがとうございます。二つ目の質問は岩下さんの方から答えいただくということです。はい。すみません。ちょっと英語で言います。So
the second question was, was there any dams that were or plans that were stopped based on public opposition?
No.
Oh, sorry.
The second question has to do with whether there have been any flooding disasters.
Oh, that's right. Sorry.
That might have been avoided if the dam were in place.
あの、質問の内容のですね、 地元では洪水が起きても構わないと思ってるんじゃないかという話です。 実際川棚川はですね、 平成22年、戦後間もなくですね、洪水に見舞われました。この時は河川改修がまだ行われてなくてですね、その後に石木ダムが計画されたわけです。この 23水ですね。この時にですね、川棚川流域にですね、5カ所のダムが計画されました。1つは出来上がっております。で、もう1つが石木ダムですけど、他のダムについては現在立ち消えております。立ち消えというよりも中止になっております。どれのダムにしても小さなダムです。これは国の経済成長の時にですね、 ダムを作れという、ただそのために出来上がった計画なんです。本当に川棚川に水、ダムが必要かというと必要ないんです。なぜかというと、その後にですね、河川改修が行われました。それによって必要なくなってきたわけです。平成7年に洪水が、平成2年にですね、川棚川で洪水がありました。これは洪水じゃなくて内水な被害なんです。 しかしその後にですね、川棚川の石木川から下流域について河川改修が行われました。これによって戦後のダムが最大のダムが来ても川棚川では洪水は起こらないと県が昨年発表しました。これを見てもですね、石木ダムが必要かというと絶対必要ないんです。強制収容までしてですね、ダムを作る必要はない。 緊急性があるからダムを作るんだと、強制収容するんだと県は言ってますけど、県自身がですね、戦後最大の洪水が来ても洪水は起こらないと明言したわけなんです。そして今もですね、100年に一度の洪水が来たらということを言われております。しかし、水源連の先生方にいろいろ 研究していただいて、一部にはいるけど、いらないと。堤防の高さをちょっと上げるだけで済むんだという結論が出ております。以上です。
So Kawatana River in Showa 23, there was a flood, and they following that flood, they had conducted some repair of the river. And at that point, they were quite confident that another flood will be mitigated. And in the Kawatana River, right around that time, they had plans for five dams, of which one has been completed. But all four of the other smaller dams, the plan has been halted. And these plans for the dam construction was brought up or surfaced during the nation's rapid economic progress for the sake of building these dams without truly analyzing whether they were necessary or not. And as far as the Kawatana watershed and the tributaries are concerned, we have found out that there is absolutely no need for any other dams because of all the repair work that they had done alongside the river to prevent any flood from occurring like the one we saw back in Heisei Nine. And as far as the prefecture's declaration of whether this construction of a dam in the Ishiki River will protect the people and the river from flooding, they have declared that due to the extensive repairs that they had done alongside the river, that they are also aware that there is that a dam is not necessary to prevent a flood from happening. So we wonder why then they still are trying to enforce the land expropriation law to take away our land to create this Ishiki Dam. And they keep maintaining their position that there is an urgency to this matter to protect the people from any water disasters so that they are going to be using the land expropriation law. However, There has also been a discussion on the possibility of a flood of a magnitude that may occur once every 100 years happening in Japan. However, on that issue as well, we've had the people like Mr. Endo of the Japan Riverkeeper Alliance and other scientists conducting extensive research on whether dams will be necessary to prevent such a magnitude, flood of such magnitude from occurring. And the consensus or the findings stated that, yes, there is a need for a dam at certain specific locations, but that most of the problems can be taken care of by doing the by raising the dike a few centimeters. That's all that will. That's all that is necessary to prevent a flood from occurring.
Okay, we've run out of time, but Mr. Tsujii wants to.
すみません。あの少しだけ補足をさせていただきたいんですが、日弁連さんが2013年に発表した意見書の中に、法律的な見地から。河川法16条2っていうのがあるんですけど、通常は2、30年に一度起こるような河川氾濫に対してきちんと川が流れるっていうことを整備しなさいっていうふうに定められています。
So this is, I would like to add some supplementary information based on the memorandum that is issued out by the Japan Federation of Bar Association. It is stated here based on the river law 2that 16.2, that for flood that may occur once every 20 or 30 years, that they are required to properly maintain so that such flooding will not occur.
で、この石木川が川棚川に合流するここの地点があるんですが、
This is the area where Kawatana River meets Ishiki River.
で、これが川棚。
This is Kawatana.
で、ここから上流は河川法にのっとって30年に一度という対策が念頭に置かれているんですけど、
So, sorry, along this line, it is under the river law, and the upstream of the Kawatana River is the subject of getting the repairs done in preparation for a flood that may occur once every 20 or 30 years.
ところがこの下流部に関しては河口までは100年に一度ということがなぜか謳われています。
However, for the downstream from where I just showed, for some reason they are using the argument or the thinking of a flood that may occur once every 100 years, not 20 to 30, but once every 100 years.
で、実際にはこの川はここから上流にいっぱい支流がありますので、流域面積自体は上流の方が大きいんですね。で、河口が小さいで逆三角形型の上郷型になってるんです。
So this river, if you divide it into the downstream and the upstream has many, many tributaries. So the surface area of the river and the water shed is actually quite large compared to the downstream. So it's almost like a reversed triangle shape.
それなのでここにダムを作るっていうことがそもそもこの上流部の河川の氾濫に全く効力がないということが一つ。
So one point is that constructing a dam right here on the Ishiki River will have absolutely no effect in stopping any flooding from occurring in those upstream areas.
で、住民が多く住んでいらっしゃるのはこの上流です。上流部になります。
はい、and many of the residents reside in this upstream area.
で、下流部に関してはこの日弁連の報告書によれば100年に一度のレベルの流量があったとしても先ほど岩下さんおっしゃった通り耐えうる稼働改修が可能であるということが分かってます。
And as far as the possibility of preventing a flood from occurring that is a magnitude of whatmay occur once every 100 years, according to the memorandum listed by the, issued by the Japan Federation of Bar Association. And as Mr. Iwashita had mentioned earlier, it is understood that it is fully preventable by the repair measures.
でこちらの資料はウェブサイトからダウンロードが可能になっております。日弁連さんのサイトです。
The memorandum?
Yes.
And this memorandum that I refer to right now is downloadable from the Japan Federation of Bar Associations website.
Okay, Lisa, this is Ikensho, is it?
Okay. And this is a letter of opinion. Sorry, I take back the word memorandum. This is a letter of opinion issued by the Japan Federation of Bar Association.
Okay. Well, I'm sorry we have to end here. We've gone way past our allotted time. We do have to vacate the room. I'd like to thank all of our guests for being here today, and thank you also for screening this interesting movie. Thank you to our interpreter, Ms. Ida. And thank you all for coming.
Thank you very much again.